I mean, I should probably look up like what the replacement blades are for that.
Yeah, or if you can even replace it.
Yeah.
Alright, we'll worry about when we get there. Okay, so this, correct, this is the picture from number 9 and 10? Okay, so for this one, I want to talk about, because a lot of people, like, I think a lot of people were struggling just with the algebra yesterday. Maybe it was the setup, but it was just like, when you get there, you didn't know what you needed to do. I was trying to say it out loud, and I thought it was an easy process, but some people just don't see that type of problem when you're in algebra. You just kind of, you have a problem set in front of you, and then you just do it. You don't actually have to set it up yourself, which is kind of weird. It throws me off when people don't do those types of problems. So this one, there's three angles here. Now, in the instructions, it says that NK, in fact, I'm going to write this down. It says up in the instructions that the rate NK bisects angle MKL or LKM. I think they have the letters switched around. That's the instructions on number 9. Let's see. KL, KN bisects, yeah. So, okay. So they have the letters switched, but it's the same concept. Okay, so, but here's the idea. If this is a bisector, so they say this NK bisects this angle. What does it mean to bisect?
Split it in half.
Yeah, splits it in half. That means both of these angles are the same. They're exactly equal to each other. That's what a bisector does. It goes right through the middle, so both angles are the same. So in fact, the one angle, the NKN, the angle on this left side here, is congruent to the other one. So we have a little congruent symbol to the other angle, which is NKL. Remember, this is the congruency symbol. It means that they're equal, like whatever the measures are. So sometimes, like on 9 and 10, they might give you both angles. They might give you this one and this one. Well, then you take whatever they give you and you set them equal. So I'm making this up. Let's say this is a 3B and this is a 2B plus 10. Well, if that's what they give you, you can set them equal to each other and then solve, right? So 3B is equal to 2B plus 10, right? They're equal angles, so you can set both of them equal and then solve for B. Now subtract 2B across, and then you can solve as 1B equals 10, so the B would be a 10, right? That's the thing. Again, I made that wrong. It's good right there. Perfect, thank you. All right, does that make sense? Like, you could do something like that. Now, the problem is on your 9 and 10, they did something goofy. They didn't just give you, you know, both angles and just said, oh, set me equal and solve. They gave you one of them and then they gave you the big one. So let's talk about that. I think that's number 9 did something like that. All right, so let's talk about 9. All right, so same setup, all these things. But number 9 talks about LKM, that's the big one, so LKM is a 7x minus 5. And this is a lot of questions were asked me yesterday. So LKM, this entire angle, is a 7x minus 5. Make sense? Entire angle, 7x minus 5. The second one is the NKM, that's the smaller one, NKM, that angle is a 3x plus 9. So NKM, this is a 3x minus or plus 9. That's the small one. Okay, that's the setup, and this is number 9 you have in your homework. Well, what I was trying to tell people yesterday is, well, what we know from the instructions, these two angles are the same. And what they gave me is they gave me this little piece, and they gave me the entire angle. Well, the thing is, like this 3x minus 9, I can write that over here. Like, I can double it. Some people are just taking it times 2, which is fine. That's the same thing. So I can write the 3x plus 9 on the other side because they're the same angle. They're the same measure, so they're the exact same variables. And now that I have that, these would add to make the big one. Does that make sense? Like, you can add the two smaller ones, and it makes the big angle. So you can set up this problem. This is your algebra problem. 3x plus 9 plus 3x plus 9 equals the 7x minus 5. Like, that's the problem. You're adding the two smaller ones, and it adds up to be the big angle. You didn't have to set up that way. I know a lot of you, like, because I was kind of explaining it out loud yesterday to a lot of you, because I thought it was kind of an easy problem to set up. But what I said for a lot of you is just double the small one. So just take 3x plus 9, double it and set that equal to 7x plus 5, or 7x minus 5. It's the same thing. Because when you add the x's and you add the 9's together, it's the same thing as doing this, because what do you have to do with the 2?
Multiply.
Yeah, you have to multiply, which is distributing, right? So that's 6x plus 18. And then you can solve this. Okay, how do you actually solve this problem? I would probably move the x across, move the 5 across. So if I move the x across, it'll become a negative 6. Move the 5 across, it becomes a positive 5. So that's like, what, 23? And that's a 1x, which I don't need a 1. So my x is a 23. That's how you do that problem. Does that make sense now? Like, that's how you do number 10 as well. 10 is almost the exact same thing. They give you NKL, they give you the JKN, and I'll explain it on here in a minute. But it's the kind of the same concept. You can do this, you know, add certain angles together. Okay, question.
So, like, for that,
yeah.
Like, MKL, is that actually 156 degrees?
So the idea is that I believe that's what they asked for, right? They asked for LKM or MKL, right? So the question was, you know, they give you the parts, and then they say find L... Ooh, geez. Find L... KM. That's what they asked for. Find the measure of it. So just like you were saying, right? You're actually right. We need to find what the measure of this angle is, like the actual number, like the 156 degrees. That's what they want. Well, how I find that, LKM is the big one, right? L to K to M. That's the big angle here. So all you need to do is just take the 23 that we found and plug it in here. Because that's my x is a 23. So if you want to find what the big angle is, take the 23 and plug it in. And you're absolutely right. Okay, because 7 times the 23, 7 times 3 is 21, carry the 2. 7 times 2 is 14 plus 2 is 161. And you subtract 5, which is 156 degrees. I did my math right in my head.
Well, like if you lay a protractor down, will it actually be 156?
No, because, if it is, it's pure luck. The reason why I know that they wouldn't draw this to scale is because they used the same picture for two different problems. Okay. So that's kind of a telltale sign that they didn't draw it to scale. It may be close, and it may be just been lucky for this first picture. It doesn't have to be perfectly to scale. Yeah, it's kind of a red flag. The minute they use the same picture for like multiple problems, and not draw to scale. It may look close, but yeah. All right. Questions on that problem, like what we do. Okay, now let me explain number 10. Now, I'm not going to do 10 because I did 9 for you, but let me explain 10 because they don't give you the exact same stuff. They give you something very similar, but it's not the exact same problem. And I'll make up letters for this one just so you can have something to go off of. Okay, for number 10, it gives you something like, it gives you LKN, and it says maybe this is like a 2B. I don't know, I'm just making that. And so that's a 2B, and then it's told me this angle over here, this one, which is different than all the rest of them. I don't even know what that angle is, but it told me that this one is a 5B plus 10, right? That's what it gave me. And I was looking at it, I was like, okay, well, how would you set this problem up? Like, what are they asking for? Well, they ask you to solve for B and then find one of the angles, like find this angle here. So maybe find the measure of angle MKN. I don't know. Like, that's the question that they kind of ask. Okay, well, the problem is, like, when you look at these, this is weird. They gave you that one over there, they give you this one. They're not even the same angle, because I know these two are. So here's the trick. Take the 2B, you transfer it over here, because these are actually the same angle, so the 2B can go here as well. And now you have three angles that are side by side, correct? They're all adjacent, they're, like, touching each other. Well, what do they add up to be? 180. Now you have your algebra problem. Now you have your algebra 1 problem where you can set up and solve for B. Because you can take that problem, add the three angles together, so 5B plus 10 plus the 2B plus the 2B, and that makes the entire straight line, which is 180 degrees, right? Because one, it's making an entire straight line when you add up the three angles, so that's 180 degrees perfectly. It's a full protractor. And now you can solve for B and plug it back. Actually, I could actually find what each of the angles are. Okay, does that make sense for number 10? Now, I made it these letters. I don't know if that's your number 10, but that's how you do 10. Okay, are we good with that? Okay, let's move on. Let's talk about, like, 39. I butchered that one. I got it wrong because I read the instructions wrong. So let me, let's go look at 39 so we can make a fix.
When I'm in Shadow's class, I can hear you writing on the board.
What was that?
When I'm in this Shadow's class,
I can just hear like,
yeah.
Yeah, sorry. I can't help that. Because I get really like into it.
Yeah.
I get the board constantly. All right. What do we got? 39?
Yeah.
Okay, 39, different picture. That's the picture. Now the instructions on 39, it's, you know, it gives you the picture, it says BH bisects, and this is the part I butchered yesterday. I didn't see this part, so I'm gonna apologize. It's BH bisects, so this line right here, B to H, is a bisector of EBC. This one. That's what I read wrong. I thought it said FBC, it said EBC. That changes a lot of problems. So it's doing the whole angle. So if this is a bisector, what does that mean again?
Split.
That means this angle right here is equal to that one. They're the same angle. Okay, whatever it is. So if it's, you know, if this is 70 degrees, that one's 70 right here. Okay? Now the other thing we know from the picture, because it does have it labeled, this little guy right here is also equal to that one, whatever these two pieces are. They're the exact same. So actually, this EB is also a bisector of this little guy, ABF, just because we know that. But neither here nor there. So let's talk about 39. Let's do this one. So 39 talks about ABF. So ABF, that is, if I label this, ABF is this angle right here. This is getting confusing. There's lots more. ABF, that is this huge angle, and it gives me what it is. It is a 7B minus 24. Okay, that's the ABF part, okay? And then it gives me ABE. ABE is a 2B. That's a 2B, that's ABE, okay? And it says find EBF. So once we've done this problem, we have to find what this mystery angle is over here. Okay, does that make sense, the setup on 39? Okay, so now if you're looking at the picture, this is a 2B. What would this one be? Yeah. Why do you know this is 2B? You are correct. Yeah, they're equal. They have the same marking. They have the same little red marker. So now you can add the two together. And that makes the big one, because the big one is the 7b minus 24. So 2b plus 2b equals 7b minus 24. Or if you're that person that doesn't like to add 2b's together, you can just double it, same. Double it, and that makes the 7b minus 24, because they're the same angle. Make sense? Once you have it, plug the b back. Now you have all the angles. So if I, you know, let's say the b turns out to be a 8. Let's say it's 8 degrees. Well, then you can take 8 and plug it back in. All the parts and you have all the angles separated. Okay, questions, comments about that? Okay, now there was also this other part on, it was like 40. I'm not going to do exactly 40, but I'll at least set it up for you just so we can talk about it. Okay, so on 40, it talked about EBC, that is this big angle over here. EBC gives me that one, the big angle. It tells me that's a 31A minus 2. And it gives me an EBH. So it gives me this one, 31A minus 2. Then it gives me EBH. Well, that's half of it. So that's this part here, EBH. So it gives me this piece, which is the 4A plus 45. Well, if this is a 4A plus 45, this is a 4A plus 45. You could add them together, and that equals the 31A plus 2, the whole thing. So that's it's the same problem we just did. It's the same as number 30. Okay, now, honest raise of hands. How many people could benefit from maybe one more day to look at this, to work on it? Okay, take it home, bring it back tomorrow. Okay, we good with that?
Yeah,
hopefully that makes sense to you. Hopefully you're like, okay, I can do that now. I'm not too worried about one of our few assignments we have this week. So take it home, work on it, it will not be late. So just make sure it is brought back tomorrow. I will not count it late as you start bringing it back tomorrow, because I'd rather have you know it than be stressed about your grades. Okay. We good though?
Can you turn it in if we go, but then we're going
to... Yeah, if you're done, you turn it. Like, you're like, eh, I'll do it. You turn it. I'm not worried about it. Okay. Let's do a couple notes today, and we're done. And if you have some time at the end of class, I'll let you work on whatever you want. Okay? You can work on this assignment, you can work on whatever you want. Remember, we have one more assignment this week, because I'm going to give you one assignment this week. So keep that in mind. It's not going to be today. We're not getting an assignment today. You have this one. I figured as much. I had too many questions throughout the whole day yesterday. I figured we were going to have questions on that problem. So let's talk about constructions today. You need to have your protractor out if you can. We're going to really practice a couple things with angles today. So you'll need your protractor. Hopefully you've been bringing that. You haven't lost it yet. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3. Good way to open that right at the right time. Perfect timing. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice. And... okay, we've got a straight edge. Remember, I'll collect those at the end of class today. We only have two constructions today, because I knew we had to talk about more, so. We've got some compasses, compi, we're drawing columns. Congruent angles. Okay, now we've talked about the word congruent. What does that mean?
Equal.
Okay, so that's the idea. These are equal angles. That's what we're going to do today. Equal angles. So we're going to try to copy an angle to a new location. We can put it anywhere you want. So what we need to do first on this particular problem, this is going to be our one of two constructions today. We need to draw an angle. Now, here's what I'm going to recommend. I'm going to recommend that we draw an acute angle first. We'll work on the obtuse one tomorrow, because we're going to do a couple constructions tomorrow. Let's work on the acute angle first. This one is it's a little bit easier for the first one. So what do we know about acute angles?
Less than 90.
Okay, so you need to draw an angle that is obviously less than 90. You do not need to measure it. It just needs to be less than 90. Now, when you draw this, make sure that the rays are pretty long, because we do have to like draw inside the picture. So don't like draw microscopically small where you can hardly see it. So I'm going to start with this. So I'm going to draw right. Remember, draw in standard position, so horizontal line. Open it up counterclockwise. This looks pretty good. Okay, that looks good. There it is. Let's label it ABC as my angle. Remember, on the homework, when they ask for what is the vertex, it's point B. And they ask for ray or sides, it's ray BA or ABC. That size of the rays, so be careful with that. Some people like things like that.
Did you use your compass?
No, I didn't use it at all. Right now, I'm just drawing a random angle. I need an angle to copy, because we're going to copy this to a new location. I don't even care. I don't even know what the measure of that thing is. I don't care about it. But we're going to copy it to a new location. Okay, so congruent angle. So keep that in mind. We are trying to draw a congruent angle. Means we're going to copy it. It's equal, size, shape, measure. Everything about it is going to be the same without using a protractor. We'll use the protractor later to check to see did we do it right. This one is getting more technical now. This one takes a little bit more effort. You really kind of have to pay attention today. This is not one that you can kind of figure out on your own by making lucky marks. Kind of specific. Okay, what we need to do first, we need to start with a ray. So does everyone have their angle drawn? It's acute, correct? Easier if it's acute. Okay, so go to somewhere else in your paper. We'll need some room. You need to draw a ray like this one, the bottom one, just horizontal, start in standard position. So just take the straight edge, draw a ray somewhere else on your paper. I'm going to go over here. That looks beautiful. Let's call it D from that ray. And if you want to put another point down the row, that's fine. Let's call it maybe E. I don't really care. But this is gonna be one of the rays of the angle. D is gonna be the actual vertex for me. Okay. And why I said we can put this anywhere? You could attach this angle to anything. I could have attached this angle like right here. So I could copy this angle to here. So now there's two of them side by side. So this would actually be the bisector in the middle because I can copy it. But I'm just going to put it over in some blank spot that I want it to be. So I'm copy the angle to a new location. Okay, is everyone good? You have your ray. Now remember, we are drawing above it, so keep that in mind. We're drawing above it because I need to copy this angle right here. So if you hug it up against it, that makes no sense because I'm going to be overlapping. It's going to look like a nightmare. Okay, because we're copying the angle. Okay. I think everyone's good. Okay, take your compass. Take your compass. You can open it up randomly, which is kind of cool. It's kind of a random mark. And what we're going to do is we're going to put the little pike on the vertex B. And what I'd like you to do is draw an arc on this angle, like this.
Anywhere?
Anywhere. So you're going to open it up random. You put the pike on B and just draw an arc. It has to hit both walls. It doesn't have to hit A or C. It's random, because you just open up your compass randomly. So remember, when you open up a compass, use that little gear in the middle. That's how you open it. Don't pull it apart. Don't be a caveman. Actually, use the gear. Okay. So put a little pike on B. You're going to draw an arc like that. The actual important parts of doing this is these locations right here. This is actually what we're looking for. We're looking for the two spots right where it hit the arc, or right where it hit the angles. Those are the important spots. Now, when you do that, don't change your compass. You got to leave your compass exactly the same. So we went here, we drew the arc, and I haven't changed yet. I'm leaving it alone. Okay, is everyone good so far? I know it's kind of easy at first. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to take this, we're going to go over to the new thing, to the new ray, and we're going to draw the same exact arc. Now, here's the problem that I'm going to have. When you draw this, I would almost say draw like a quarter of a circle. So start almost at the top where like 90 degrees is, and put the pike on D. Start where like 90 degrees is, and then work your way down until you hit the ray E. D, I should say. The ray. So I'm making almost a quarter circle. Because I knew my angle had to be less than 90, because we're doing a cube. So I'm going to draw a 90 for sure, like I'm going straight up and down, and then I'm going to work my way down. The important spot, did you hit the wall somewhere over here? That's the important thing. If you didn't, you need to keep drawing. And again, do not change the compass. So you went to the original one, you drew the arc, you went over here, draw the arc. Okay, we're good? Most people are pretty good at this one. This is pretty straightforward. Okay, we're good? Looks like everyone's good. They only need more time? Okay, now here comes the tricky part. This is the part that I lose people because they don't pay attention. You need to, now we need to change the compass. We need to like use your little gear in the middle, and we need to figure out where these two marks are. So you need to measure these marks right here. Right where the arc actually hit my original angle ABC, these two spots. I don't care about A and C. I care about where these two arcs were. It's basically what I call it, we're measuring the gap of the angle. We're actually kind of measuring what this angle is from here to where it actually made the mark. Again, I'm using the two spots that I circled. For some people, that really throws them off. They want to use A and C. I don't care about those points. In fact, you could erase A and C for all I care. It doesn't really matter. Okay, did everyone measure their angle? You figured out your gap like this? That takes the longest time because you have to change the gear now. And you have to make sure those arcs were originally drawn before you do this. Now that you've done that, you can pick up your compass if you've actually had this measured. Don't change it. There's your angle, right? You're going to go over to the new picture, and you're going to put the little pike on the bottom, and you're going to make a mark up here in the air. And it should cross. The reason why I know it should cross is because when you drew this arc, you drew a quarter circle, which is almost 90 degrees. Well, my angle's less than 90, so we should be able to hit over here somewhere. And again, you should be able to draw kind of lightly, and you should be able to make this little X marks the spot. Again, I put the pipe right where the circle was, right where the arc hit, and make a mark. I don't care about DE, I care about where the arc actually hit. That's the spot I'm using. Make that mark up in the air. So again, doing that. Once you have that, guess what you can do?
Draw a line.
You're practically done. You're going to draw the line from D out to X marks the spot using your straight edge, like this. Now again, I'm telling you right now, this is more technical. Like, if you weren't paying attention, this one is definitely different. It's difficult. This angle should be the same as this one now. They should be exactly the same. In fact, they don't look too bad. Mine don't. For freehand drawing it for the most part. Anyone need help on that one? I know this is one more tangle. I will have all the instructions online. Plus, you can go watch the video. I'll try to type it by hand. I did that yesterday for you guys. I think the website's up to date, so you can watch the videos again from yesterday. Some people like to see those videos. And in fact, I think tomorrow we're going to really look at a website that offers like constructions. Like, it'll show you how to draw certain constructions again, too. Okay, are we good with that one? Does anyone need help? Now, take your protractor, measure it. Does it look good? I'm going to measure mine. So I'm putting the vertex down, I'm lining up zero. Mine's about a 60 degree angle, so it's pretty close to 60. And measure it over here, yeah, pretty close to 60. I was a little bit off. Yeah, actually it's pretty close. It's just kind of where you put your little peg at. Does it look good? It's close enough. Okay. If you were taking your time and you knew this one very, very well, and you're taking your time to make markings, it's exact. It's right on. Okay, we good? Everyone's got that one? All right. Last one today. It's our last construction. This one is actually really straightforward. It's actually really easy compared to this one. This one takes the most work. Especially when we get to, we're going to try this one tomorrow, this exact congruent angle one. We're going to do it for obtuse. Oh my goodness, you will not believe how many people get this next one wrong tomorrow. The obtuse one, for some reason, it's more difficult because of this thing. When you're drawing the arc, a lot of people never draw the arc long enough, and it's a nightmare trying to fix that. Okay, so we're going to move to a new place on your paper. Now, on this one, we're just going to draw one object, and we're going to draw in the middle of it, so you don't need a lot of room, like crazy amount of room. Okay, so this is our last construction today. We're gonna draw an angle. So let's stick with an acute angle today. Acute angle. Now, what does acute mean?
Less than 90.
Okay. Less than 90 degrees. So you can take your straight edge, just draw a random one. Don't use your protractor. Just draw a random acute angle. I know some people are like, well, Ward, why don't you just use the last one? Try to keep your construction separate. So we're not mixing them together and you don't know which construction we're doing. So, drawing acute, less than 90. So, again, draw it in standard position. Standard position has that horizontal line going to the right. This looks good. That's beautiful. And let's call it X, Y, and Z. X, Y, and Z. We don't use those letters too often. Okay, what we're going to do on this particular drawing is we are going to bisect our angle. So we're going to draw basically an angle bisector. Now, what do you remember about angle bisectors or bisectors in general?
Split in half.
So we are going to, at some point, draw a perfect ray or line or segment, whatever you want to call it, that's going right in the middle. But you're not freehand drawing. We're going to use the compass and figure this out, which I think is pretty awesome. Okay, but I need to make sure everyone has a chance. Did everyone get an angle drawn? Basically, all we're going to do is draw in the middle of it, so that's kind of cool. So that's all we're going to be doing. Everyone's got their angle drawn. Check. Camera's still going. Okay. Okay, all right, take your compass. This first mark is going to be very similar to the last problem we just did. So you're going to put a little pike right on the vertex, point Y, that's my vertex. and we're going to draw an arc. And it needs to hit both walls, like that.
So it has to hit both walls.
And again, it was random, right? I don't even care how far you open up your compass. You just put a little Python point Y, the vertex, and draw an arc. Now, in drafting, they just say just leave your compass the same. Don't change it. Just leave it the same, and you can go from there, which is kind of easy. I always tell differently, but I'll show you why. Okay, so does everyone have that first arc drawn? Did it hit both walls? Okay, now these are the important spots on the circle. These are the important spots right here and here. I don't care about X, and I don't care about Z. I care about where those two little spots are, right where the arc actually hit my angle. Okay, without changing my compass, you're going to put the pike on one of them. So I'm going to put the pike on this bottom spot right where I have that circle drawn. So I'm going to put the pike there, and I'm going to draw a little arc out here in the middle, where I think the middle of my angle is. It's out here. So I'm going to draw a little arc. When you have that little mark made using, you know, the pike right on this spot and then the pencil out here, you're going to go up to the other one and do the same thing, and it should make an X marks the spot. Again, how I'm doing that, put a little pike on that little arc spot, on the other arc location, and you should be making an X floating out in the middle. And again, you're using these locations, don't use X and Z. Use these spots here. So that's how I'm making my little X. And what do you think we can do last? Draw a line. And so I'm going to take my little straight edge, go from Y out to X marks the spot, and that should be the perfect bisector of my angle. In fact, you can measure them, see if they're the exact same. They are. Now, in drafting, that's how they teach that. That particular problem is called an angle bisector. We can cut an angle in half perfectly. In geometry, I do this construction a little bit different. It's not necessary because this is very easy, right? You make an arc, you just use that arc, and you don't even change your compass. What I always tell people is when you make your original arc like this, because I haven't even changed my compass yet, so I made my original arc. I always tell people do like what we did in the last construction. You measure the gap, the angle, measure the gap from here to here, and then that's where you make your little mark. It's not a big deal. It'll be the same thing. It brings it in a little bit closer. I always think that measuring this gap and bringing it in closer is easier. That way you don't use as much paper. Because if you draw a really big arc and you don't change your compass, right? And you don't change your compass and you use where the arc is, you're way out here. You're way off the paper sometimes. So if you re-measure the gap, it potentially brings the X closer to the actual center, even though it's on the same line. It's the same exact marking. It's right on the bisector line anyway. I just think it uses less paper. So that's a little word of wisdom if you're getting close to the edge of your paper. Okay, questions, comments? Okay, that's it for today. That's all I want to cover. Very nice, very easy. You have the remaining part of class, about 7 minutes? 7 minutes? Where you can work on your homework. Page 41, if you want to take it home, because I know I went through the review of it earlier, if you want to take it home and refix maybe number 9 or 10, or maybe finish it, maybe you didn't know how to do them, and maybe you want to work on 37 through 40, do that. I'm going to walk around the room, I'm going to collect my protractors and my straight edges, please. So try to put the compasses...
protractors?
Oh, compasses, sorry, compass. So put those back in their little bangies. And I'll walk around them. I'll collect the straight edges next. So. And I'll walk around the room and collect. Perfect.
type of a chest plate.
Yes.
What? What type of a chest plate?
Hey, I'm gonna hand back some paper. So when I say your name, just raise your hand. So I hand back some old paper to you. Okay. I'm gonna turn on the paper.